Hi, everybody. Welcome to my crib. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Priscilla, and I'm so excited today because I'm finally showing you guys Audrey's nursery, and I'm finally filming this nursery tour. I hope that wherever you are in the world that you are safe, happy, and healthy. By the way, everything that I show you guys, I will link down below in the description box. If for some reason YouTube doesn't let me link everything, I also have a blog post that I'll link below that has pictures of everything and you know, clickable photos and links. That way, if there's anything that inspires you that you like, you can easily find. I hope you guys enjoy this nursery tour in this video. If you do, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Okay, so let's start off with the big reveal. Here is a basic overview of Audrey's nursery. We were going for a modern and girly space. We do not have an official theme, but unofficially it is ballerinas and bows. You will see touches of that throughout the space. And the color scheme in her room is white, light pink, and gray. I figured I'd start off by showing you guys the crib since it serves as the main focal point for the nursery. This is the crib we bought off Amazon for less than $200. It is white, modern, and a larger sized crib. Inside, we decorated it with a ballerina and bows crib sheet, as well as some plush toys.
By the way, this is a very special bear. When you push it in the middle, that is Audrey's heartbeat when she was, I don't know, I think maybe six months in my belly. We did a 4D ultrasound and they record the heartbeat and put it in the little stuffed animals. So this is something that's very special.
So right above the crib, we have this beautiful flower mural. This is actually something that we did ourselves. It's funny because I had this idea of putting a beautiful flower wall in her room above her crib, and I had no idea that it was actually a thing that other people have done it to. So in a way that was interesting because at least I was able to see some inspo. But we went ahead and just made this ourselves. You can buy it made, just completely made together, like through Etsy. It did seem kind of expensive to me that way, but if you want just a creative project that you and the family can do together, something special for the nursery, this is a really great way to do it. We bought all these pieces from Hobby Lobby, and they ranged anywhere from $3 to $10, I believe. So for example, the tiny little baby ones in here were, I think, $2.99. And then the bigger pieces like this one were closer to $10. But, you know, it can get pricey. But again, I think it's just easier to do it yourself. We also got some of the, I don't know what it's called. It's like the sticky backs for walls. And that is how these are actually staying up. I'm sure there's other ways, but that's just the way that we did it. And again, I have to give my husband credit because although this was my idea, he completely executed this. So one tip that I have in your nursery space that you'll have to do from the beginning is to get a really beautiful rug that you can kind of like set the foundation for the nursery. We went with this one. It is gray and white, and we got this one at Home Goods. I believe it was about $100, and it might be kind of hard for me to link it below, but I'll definitely try to find similar ones. But I just feel like a really nice rug pulls everything together, especially, you know, when it complements the rest of the nursery space. And to be honest, if we didn't have this rug here, like, the nursery would really be missing something. So that is one tip that I have for you.
So this is the rocking chair that we chose. We actually did a lot of research and we ended up finding this one off of Amazon as well. It was, I think, just under $300, and I have to say it's really well made and so comfortable. I knew I wanted like either a cream or a white color, so this is actually the cream color. I believe this glider comes in like maybe 5 different colors.
Also, you guys know I love Z Gallery, so I wanted to find a couple pieces from there that I could put in her nursery, and I found this beautiful throw blanket in like a really pretty blush colored pink. I know Z Gallery has this in several colors, so if you have maybe a boy nursery that you're putting together, I know they have like a dark gray color. I'm not sure about blue. So right above the glider, Obsessed with Tiny Dancer by Elton John. I just think it's such a beautiful song. And of course, Audrey is my little tiny dancer in my heart. So I had an idea again about framing the lyrics. And the first thing I did was to Google it to see if this was actually something that was sold. And I was surprised to find a couple of different sellers on Etsy. And then there was like one online store that sold this, as well as Pottery Barn Kids. What I found with Pottery Barn Kids is that for the print alone, I think it was $45, and then you still have to buy a frame for it. So we just decided to do it ourselves. We had the print made, and then I bought a frame from Michaels, and it came out really, really beautifully.
So if this is something that interests you, just know that it can be very easy to do yourselves and very affordable. Obviously, this is what I chose, but maybe there's like a special quote or a prayer or maybe lyrics from a song or from a movie that are special to you and your family. Just know that you can frame it, and it can be really easy and fun to do.
And although this is quite simple, this is something I knew I wanted to have in her room, and in my thought process, I figured right next to the glider, you know, that it could go here, this little white stool. I went back and forth between getting a white one or a pink one, but I'm really glad that I chose the white one. It's just a cute little accent piece, and I believe it was only $30 from Burlington. So when I first started doing research for decor for Audrey's room, I stumbled across this Mongolian fur lamb rocker from Pottery Barn Kids and absolutely fell in love with it. It does come in black as well, and I will say it's a little bit more on the expensive side, but to me it's one of those like statement pieces in the room and the nursery that just makes all the difference. And of course it serves multiple purposes because it is beautiful for her room, but also she'll be able to play with it for years to come. So I knew I wanted some kind of play gym for this area here, just because I needed to put something here in the nursery in the space. So for now I went with this play gym. This is more on the modern side, definitely more unique. They do have these mostly like on Etsy, and I've seen them like there's a few on Amazon, and then I forget the name of the store that I got this from, but again I'm gonna link it below. But I'm really happy with how it turned out. They sent all the pieces and then we put it together. It was very simple, and Audrey absolutely loves playing on this little mat, and she just goes crazy with these little hanging toys. The one that they have on Amazon that I've seen is actually all wood. This one I paid a little more for so that we could actually get the white and wood together to match her room better.
And this is actually the newest thing that we've added to our nursery space, or to Audrey's nursery, and it's this beautiful swing.
So we got this one also off of Amazon. I believe it was $60. So compared to some other online stores, this was a really good deal, and it had really good reviews as well, which is why we chose it. It's actually made from natural cotton cords, so it is very durable and beautiful, and the design of it is just really impressive, and Audrey absolutely loves this swing. We can move it outside later if we want to, but if you are going to get a baby hammock swing, I think this is definitely the one to go with. And my husband was actually able to hang it here from our ceiling. I did want to mention that some of these swings are actually not made to actually swing, but this one is. So if you're looking for one that is functional as well, this one is functional. Audrey loves it, but I think a lot of people use it for decor, like just as like a decor piece, because you can always just sit your baby in there and they can be in place once they can sit up on their own. But if you're looking for, you know, a hammock swing that actually swings, again, I highly recommend this one.
This is the dresser and the changing table that we went with. This is from the brand Delta Children. When we were doing our research, I wanted something, again, that was white, that would match the crib, something that was modern, minimal, and functional. And this dresser has definitely done the trick. It is on the more medium size.
So let me open each drawer just so I can show you how I have it organized. This top drawer just has all of her shoes, including a couple of very special pair. This is actually her first pair of Converse shoes that were given to her by her grandma Loretta. In this drawer, I mostly have some plush swaddles in here, as well as towels. And then in the bottom drawer, let's see, I have some pants back here. I have these Juicy Couture swaddle blankets that I actually haven't even opened yet, and some bloomers. And I believe in this drawer I have multiple blankets in here. These are like the thick plush blankets. I like to have 2 to 4 of these on hand. Underneath that drawer, we have some travel sets in here for her. And then in the bottom drawer, we have some socks as well as some little bonnets and beanie hats. By the way, how cute is this? This was actually used as a gift bag and it was given to me at my baby shower, but I decided to keep it since I knew I definitely wanted to go with like a ballerina kind of theme in her room. So I just think it's so beautiful. Of course, I use it as decor, but I also use it to store all of Audrey's beautiful bows. And then this is the way I have it styled on top of the dresser. So this is the changing table. It comes paired with the dresser, but it's actually like you can buy it separately, which is what we did. This is the same print, the ballerina and bows print that matches the crib sheet. If you are looking for like a modern storage bin, I know this is like such a small thing in the nursery, but I was very particular. I wanted one that looked, you know, modern and matched the room. This one is from Pottery Barn Kids and it comes with another piece that is quite similar but smaller to it. This one, however, fits perfectly in the space that we had allotted. So we went with this one and we're able to kind of use it like as a diaper caddy, but it's very functional and we keep her diapers in here and anything else that we need. How cute is this teether? This particular version, I forget the brand, but they sell it at a bunch of different stores. And they all say different things, so different colors, and they have different little sayings on them. Audrey loves this teether as well, so I will do my best to link one below for you. By the way, this is my favorite toy stacker that I found online. This one is from Pottery Barn Kids, and I believe it does come in multiple sizes, so this is the jumbo size. So these shelves were actually put in 5 years ago, and they have definitely held up. So I like them because you can, you know, put nice little decor like we have here. This is actually a photo from Audrey's newborn shoot, and these ballet shoes right here are not just decorative, they're also a piggy bank. And then next to it over here, I have some more added touches from Z Gallery, this frame as well as this little ballerina trinket box are both from Z Gallery and totally worth it. They are so beautiful. So besides actually just loving the name Audrey, I'm also a really big Audrey Hepburn fan. So that is kind of the story behind this special gift here, which was gifted to Audrey on Easter from a family friend. This is her first official piece from Tiffany & Co. I know she is a very lucky, loved little girl. So one tip I have for the closet space is to get these matching hangers. These are actually from Target and they come in white or gray as well. Another tip I have is to organize your baby's clothes from dark colors to light colors. By the way, how beautiful are some of these dresses here? This one, she can't wear yet till she's about 1, but I just love finding these beautiful little dresses for her. So I went ahead and pulled out the Snuggle Me Organic just so you can see it. I get so many questions about this piece on social media, mostly because I took a lot of photos of Audrey in this, but it's actually quite practical as well and very comfortable for babies since it conforms to their shape. So this is definitely a baby lounger that is an investment, but it's something that can be passed down as well, and I highly recommend it. And look who decided to wake up just in time for the end of the video. Well, that concludes the nursery tour, guys. I really enjoyed walking you around the space and just showing you all of the beautiful things that we have added to Audrey's nursery. I hope you found some inspiration either for your own nursery or maybe as a gift for someone else. If you have any questions about anything, just leave me a comment below. And of course, you can always follow me on Instagram for daily inspo and content. And if you liked this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. I will see you next week in my next video.